Dear friends, welcome to RPA tutorials. In this video, we will cover the smart recorder in a demonstration of how to use it and the object cloning command. At the time this video is created, the latest version of Automation Anywhere client is 10.7. Smart recorder is used when you want to record a task or a series of actions on your computer while building tasks that require capturing objects from applications that use HTML, Java, WPF, Flex or Silverlight. It also captures coordinates and image of the sections of the screen where the action is being performed while recording the task. Smart Recorder is a powerful tool and help captures Windows objects and controls such as text from drop-down menus, list boxes, buttons, mouse click actions, status from radio buttons, and check boxes. While running the task, it allows the user to define which properties to choose while searching for objects on the screen. Let us now have a look at the demonstration of Smart Recorder in the object cloning command.
For the purpose of this demo, we'll be automating a simple Windows administration task of changing the battery setting to from one mode to another mode in control panel. Let me just perform the steps for you. So we'll go into security, system and security, go into power options, and then we'll switch the power plan to Dell from balanced. So let's switch this back to balanced. Now, in order to record this task, in order to automate this task, we'll be using the smart recorder for the purpose of this demo. We can choose to start the smart recorder either by clicking on new and selecting smart recorder here, or we can click on the record button. Now, to start the smart recorder from the record button, ensure that smart recorder is selected in the drop down next to the record button. It is selected here, so we click on record. Now in smart recorder, it asks us to choose the window on which the actions need to be performed. Now contrary to the web recorder, it will not open the window on its own. The window needs to be open before we start recording. In this case, the window is control panel, so we select start. You can see the recording has started. Now we'll click on system and security. That was our first step. We'll click on power options. And then we'll click on Dell. To stop recording, we'll click on stop. It asks for a file name, so we'll choose smart recorder demo as the file name for this task. There you go. You can see the task has been created. Now to edit the task, you can click on, well, it opens up automatically after some time. Great. Otherwise, you can also right click on the task and click on edit, and then the task will open up in task editor like this. So as you can see, the three tasks have been captured. The three activities have been captured in the task, and all of them have been captured using the command object cloning. So the smart recorder, whatever steps you perform in the foreground are captured in the background using the object cloning command. Let's deep dive into this command by right clicking one of the lines and select edit. So this is the object cloning window. So for every click, it captures three things. It captures the object values, it captures coordinates where the click or the action was performed, and captures the image of the part of the screen where the action was performed. So let's select object first and click on expand search criteria. As you can see, it populates a lot of the values for these properties once you've made the click. So for example, the name gets populated as system and security. The type is link. There is a path also which gets captured. Then there are some coordinate details which are captured here. Maybe this is the relative position of the click from the top left corner of the screen. And you can, as you can see, some other properties are also captured here. Now the binoculars that you see in front of these properties basically is used to select the properties which will be used to identify the link or the radio button or the checkbox or the place where the click or the keystroke has to be made during runtime. So if I say, if so for example, here you can see name, type, and path are selected. So when I run this task, when I'll run this task during runtime, the object cloning command will use these three values to find that object that needs to be clicked on the screen. Now I can obviously add some more properties which I would want the automation in the client to consider while searching for that link or drop down on the screen where the action needs to be performed. Or similarly, I can reduce the properties as well. So we'll stick to the default which was there earlier, and we'll select OK. Similarly, now it also captures the coordinates of where the click or the action was performed on the screen, and it also captures the image of what was clicked or what action was performed and where on the screen. So all these three things are captured using the object cloning command. Now in the play mode, essentially what play modes is that during runtime, which of these three options do you want the client application, the Automation Anywhere client, to consider while searching for the object on the screen on which the action needs to perform? So if you select object, it will use these three properties. If you select coordinates, it will use these coordinates and perform the selected action at these coordinates. And if you select image, it will search for this image, and you can also specify a confidence criteria here and then select the action to be performed if you select image. So we'll stick to object for this one, and can also add a certain delay in case you think that the system might take some time to show this particular window or that particular part of the application on which the action is being performed. We'll save this. Oh, so we did not select an action, so we'll select left click, we'll save it, and we are back on the task action list screen. Now similarly, we'll check for the other two commands. There you go, it's all captured perfectly. So we'll keep it to object as well, or we'll just select coordinates in this one, and let's select the option to be performed is left click. And the radio button, now let's open this up. The coordinates are also captured. See, on this one the image is not captured properly. So what we can do is we can click on the recapture image button and then recapture the image. Now just notice one thing. Now we have captured the image wherein the Dell is selected, so wherein when the task will be performed, Dell is not selected. So we'll switch this back to balanced, and then we'll come back to the task and recapture it again, so that we're able to provide this the same level of environment that it will find during runtime. And we'll select image. We will select left click. And we'll select save. Now, as I mentioned earlier, the window needs to be opened in when you're using the smart recorder to record a task or a set of activities. Now we can, in the task editor, actually manually add a command to open the control panel for us, so that the task is not dependent on a person or a human being to manually open the control panel so that the task can run on it. So we will now use the open program file command. We'll just write control. Automation Anywhere automatically picks this up as control panel. We'll move this to this upwards, or we'll just right click it and click on move up. Now your system might take some time to open the control panel, so this is not a mandate, but you can just, to fail proof the bot, you can add a delay. And to add the delay, you need to add the delay command. Here you go, that's the delay command, and you can add a regular delay of, can select seconds, and I can add a regular delay of 5 or maybe 10 seconds. to ensure that the control panel is opened, and then these activities, the object loading activities, start to take place. Now we'll now save the task, and we will switch off, or we'll just close the control panel. We'll close the task editor window and then select the task and run it. As you can see, the task is loading in the bottom right part of the screen. Control panel is open. We added a 10 second delay, so it's waiting for the delay to end. We are inside system and security, inside power option, and the Dell setting has been selected. So we have just witnessed that all three facets of Smart Recorder are working fine. The first step was performed using the object values which were captured. Let me just open the task editor again. The first step was performed using the object property values that were captured. The second one was performed using the coordinate values of the link on the screen. And the third one was performed using an image search.
This brings us to the end of this video. If you like our videos, subscribe to our channel below, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and connect with us on LinkedIn. Links in description below.